The banking throughout the world has changed a lot in the last few decades. From physical banking, we have moved to a digital era. Today, we will be discussing the new era of banking, that is the digital era, wherein with our experts, we will be discussing about artificial intelligence in banking, fintech solutions in banking, and data analytics, machine learning, voices, biometrics, and also about the various cyber securities. Banking has been through a paradigm shift in the last decade. Digitalization in the banking has changed the banking at a very large extent. It is not only helping the customers, but along with it, the bankers also. Banking nowadays is more dependent on the data than on anything else. Machine learning, data analytics are something which is changing the banking for the bankers. Today, bankers have a huge number of data available of the customer in relation to their ATM transactions, their shopping preferences, their preferences of loans, their digital and internet searches. These data can be served and used through data analytics for providing better services to the customers. Today, bankers don't ask us what our requirement is. Instead, they come to us and provide a service that is more suitable for us. Many times it happens that when a banker offers us a product, we realize, oh yes, it was required by us. This has been possible through data analytics. Data analytics is also helping in managing better customer credit risk, because it helps us to understand and helps the banker to understand that how we are using our credit, what is our credit repayment pattern, have we diverted the funds anywhere else. That is one of the reasons that data analytics are now helping us in averting many frauds. Along with it has joined the hands machine learning and artificial intelligence. Machine learning is helping the customer to learn various concepts of banking through machines. We are less dependent on the bankers and more dependent on the machines. Along with it, machine learning is helping the banker to understand the customer requirement, their fraud tendency, their credit requirements, and the requirements of various financial products. Machine learning is changing the banking at a very large extent. If we take a combination of data analytics and machine learning, the banking in the coming years will have a different mode and medium, wherein machines will be replacing the human banking, as the machines know us much more than our own bankers. Customer relationship management has become very easy through machine learning and data analytics. For an example, a customer may have his birthday on a particular day. These things are helping us to know what are our customer preferences, whether they like any kind of special sweets or something else. Thus, customer appeasement also helps us in doing so.
Ma'am, just want to ask you a question. That we have talked about data analytics and machine learning. Apart from this, is there any other system which is helping both the bankers and the customers?
Yes, Pavandeep ji. A very new system that has just entered the Indian banking in 2017 is voices. Voices is an old concept for the banks outside India, but it's very new in India. Still, we are working on it. The best of its examples are SBI SIA, ICICI IPL, HDFC EVA, etc. These modes where voices are used, here there is no human interference. Here certain options are created for you to for your query to be raised. For an example, like you want to know what kind of NRI accounts are available with SBI Bank. So, you will just go to SIA and the predetermined questions are available. So, you can ask You can just click on NR accounts, okay, and SIA will start giving you answers what kind of NR accounts are available. The next step is very easy. It is just like chatting to a normal human. Voices is the new mode that is entering the banking. Here you don't get a feeling that you're not tech talking to any human. It gives a feeling that as if a person is attending you. Machine learning, data analytics and voices, a combination of three, is the digital revolution entering the banking in India. Let me assure you one thing. With these sources in hand, the credit risk will be mitigated, frauds will be avoided, and better customer service are for sure on our ways. Thank you. So we have amongst us our expert, Dr. Pavandeep Kaur Bindra, who will be throwing light on cybersecurity and biometric system.
Dhanyavad, Nishtaji. So, we have just seen like 2000 to 2009, it's an era of branch walk-ins, where the maximum the customers, they walk into the branch and they do the transactions. But from 2009 to 2019, its era has been drastically changed, and because there's a lot of digital transactions have taken place, UPIs, 24/7 banking concept has been come. The more banking is based on mobile banking, SMS banking, internet banking. But now what we'll witness from 2019 to 2025 onwards is more related to robotics, chatbots, wearables. So thus we can say that banking is getting changed.
So don't you think, Pavandeep ji, that with all this modern techniques coming in, the cyber risk is also increasing day by day?
You're perfectly all right, Nishtha ji. Like with the increase in digitalization, cyber risk also increases, and with this only, the bank has nowadays they shift their focus to the cyber security, which is a very important and very vital concern in a banking industries. There are various factors that led to the development of cyber security. Is one is obviously digitalization. The second one is it's more cost effective. Third one is a competition from peers. And the fourth one is related to like the customers nowadays, they can't compromise with their better customer service. So that is also one of the important factor. So we may also say this, that cyber threat is a universal phenomena, and banks are also a part of the cyber place. The type of the cyber threats we may see, like there are various type of cyber threats which is proning to the banking industry, is like phishing is there, wishing is there, skimming is there, malware is there, ransomware is there. So these are some of the frauds that are related to the cyber frauds. So now increase in cyber crimes is in data, like in 2008 to 2019, there is around 46% of increase in a cyber crime, because as the digital transactions is going on with the same pace, cyber frauds are also going on. So banking business is based on trust and credibility. This I can see with my personal experience of 8 years, that the customer believes you, he trusts you, that is why he is having an account with you. So it is vital for the banking to provide them a cyber security. And also this cyber threat, cyber risk leads to loss of time, loss of money, loss of data. So that too is also, we can't ignore the fact. There are significant ongoing efforts by RBI in setting cyber security framework. Like RBI in July 2016, they have issued a comprehensive circular on cyber security, is, and the some of the features are that bank have to form the cyber security policy. Second is CCMP, that is cyber crisis management plan. Every bank has to form that. Third is bank have to organize the awareness session for various stakeholders. And the last one is regular cyber audit by RBI, else their license will be in danger. So, in addition to this, we may also say that following tools are available for cybersecurity, like anti-phishing, vulnerability management, and more about malware monitoring. So, because of these cyber risk, like foreign banks nowadays, Indian banks, they have also started using a biometric authentication based banking. So, according to Tech SCI report, the biometric market in India will grow up to 31% from 2016 to 2021. This includes Aadhaar-enabled payment services, and let's see how this works. So just give you an example. Suppose a customer visit to a branch for getting his funds transferred. So first of all, the account is linked to the Aadhaar, and on the basis of this, first of all, the demographic authentication takes place, and secondly, the biometric authentication takes place, that is on the basis of facial geometry, DNA, fingerprints, etc. So for example, even the twins, they don't have same fingerprints, so that is very educate, and we find there will be very less errors, chances of less errors in this. So the third is like after biometric authentication, the OTP has been sent to the customer mobile number, and thus the transaction of the execution will be done. So why biometric? So obviously there are various factors, like why the reason biometric authentication is nowadays a ongoing phenomena. First is it's in highly secure, cost effective, and first of all, it's very important that it lifts the burden of remembering passwords. We have a lot of passwords nowadays, different passwords for email, ATM, debit card. Sometimes we ourselves are forget like which password is available for which app. So this also reduces this risk. Now just here, I just want to quote the example of the two pioneer bank who are doing wonders in biometric authentication. First is an Axis Bank iris scan biometric authentication. That is on the basis of the retina of the eyes. If the customer has gone, the transaction will take place. And the ICICI bank based voice recognition, that is on the basis of, as you have already mentioned, ma'am, that voices also plays a, nowadays it's changing the era of the banking. So voice based recognition, that on the basis of the voices, the transaction will take place. So in the conclusion, I just want to say everybody is going for digital transactions, but at the same time, cyber threat is also there. Hackers are ready to hack your data. But so at the same time, it's very important for a banking industry for cyber security. And in cyber security, along with this biometric authentication, it provides a cushion to the banking for the smooth functioning of the industry.
Artificial intelligence is the future of banking, as it brings the power of advanced data analytics to combat fraudulent transactions and improve compliance. AI algorithm accomplishes anti-money laundering activities in few seconds, which otherwise take hours and days. AI also enables banks to manage huge volumes of data at record speed to derive valuable insights from it. Features such as AI bots, digital payment advisors, and biometric fraud detection mechanisms lead to higher quality of services to a wider customer base. All this translates to increased revenue, reduced cost, and boost in profits. AI also helps in strengthening competitiveness of banks. So, let's see what the points are for that. Firstly, AI develops a better understanding of customers and their behavior. This enables banks to customize financial products and services by adding personalized features and intuitive interactions to deliver meaningful customer engagement and build strong relationships with its customers. Secondly, with its power to predict future scenarios by analyzing past behaviors, AI helps banks predict future outcomes and trends. This helps banks to identify fraud, detect anti-money laundering pattern, and make customer recommendations. Thirdly, cognitive process automation. It enables automation of a variety of information-intensive, costly, and error-prone banking services like claims management. This reduces cost and ensures accurate and quick processing of services at each step. Cognitive process automation fundamentally automates a set of tasks that improves upon their previous interventions through constant machine learning. Fourthly, chatbots. They identify the context and emotions in the text chat and respond to it in the most appropriate way. These cognitive machines enable banks to save not only time and improve efficiency, but also help banks to save millions of dollars as a result of cumulative cost savings. Fifthly, effective decision making. Cognitive systems that think and respond like human experts provide optimal solutions based on available data in real time. These systems keep a repository of expert information in its database called knowledge database. Bankers use these cognitive systems to make strategic decisions. Lastly, robotic automation of processes. AI reviews and transforms processes by applying robotic process automation. This enables automation of about 80% of repetitive work processes, allowing knowledge workers to dedicate their time in value-add operations that require high level of human intervention.
Dr. Kyati, is there any integration of for mobile apps in banking?
Yes, of course. Most of the banks have started embracing AI and related technologies worldwide. As per the survey by National Business Research Institute, over 32% financial institutions use AI by the means of voice recognition and predictive analysis. Banks are using AI technology for enhancing the customer experience by giving it a personalized touch. Millennials rely heavily on mobile banking, which means that AI-powered banking mobile apps can attract them. Such apps can readily meet the user's expectations with the personal, contextual, and predictive services. These are intelligent apps that can track the user's behavior and give those personalized tips and insights on savings and expenses. Moreover, it is also easy for a banking app integrated with AI-related features to show services, offers, and insights in line with the user's behavior. When it comes to personalized planning, AI banking apps can work wonders. It is easy to assist the users in financial planning for all strategies. For example, if the user wants to buy a new house, the mobile banking app can guide the user with the budget and other related details on the basis of current expenditure and income. Now, let's talk about few examples. Like State Bank of India, the largest bank in India, last year conducted Code for Bank hackathon to encourage developers to build solutions leveraging futuristic technologies such as AI and blockchain into banking sector. Private bank like HDFC Bank and ICICI Bank have already introduced chatbots for customer service. Some have even gone ahead with placing robots for customer service. Last year, Canara Bank installed Mini Mitra and Candy robots at some of its offices. So now, if I want to conclude this, it says that AI will not only empower banks by automating its knowledge workforce, it will also make the whole process of automation intelligent enough to do away with cyber risk and competition from fintech players. AI will enable banks to leverage human and machine capabilities to optimally to derive operational and cost efficiencies and deliver personalized services. All of these benefits are no longer a futuristic vision to accomplish for banks. By adopting AI, leaders in the banking sector have already taken actions with due diligence to reap these benefits.
Financial institutions, financial procedures, and financial services have drastically evolved and improved in the last few decades. With the evolution of technology, the entire industry has undergone a massive transformation that has changed the way the financial procedures are carried out and the way the financial institutions operate. The collaboration between finance and technology has led to a radical change in several aspects of finances like banking, investment, trading, cryptocurrency, and more. This evolution has led to the popularity of the term called fintech. Fintech is much more than just a reference to financial technology. It is often referred to as the innovative technology that is used to improve the traditional financial methods and develop effective solutions for financial services, which are at par with the latest technological trends. Banking software and mobile banking applications are the classic examples of development in financial technology. Like every other country, India has also experienced marvels of financial technology in banking and finance sector. For India, which is a cash-driven economy, this is a step towards creating a cashless society. With range of fintech services and fintech software, it has changed the way the people carry out their daily transactions and handle their money. This dynamic transformation brought upon by the Association of Technology and Financial Sector has opened a gateway for fintech ecosystem in India. The current fintech ecosystem in India consists of startups, digital payment players, insurance companies, and big tech players like Amazon, Google Pay, and Facebook-owned WhatsApp. Google rolled out its India-centric Tez, while both Samsung and Amazon introduced its Samsung Pay and Amazon Pay. On the other hand, there are homegrown digital payment firms like Paytm, PhonePay, MobiWik, and FreeCharge, which are all UPI-enabled and are strengthening their arsenal. Interestingly, Paytm, which is India's largest online payments and mobile wallet company, has invested $786 million in mobile payments to date. At its nascent stage, this sector seems to be growing at a very rapid pace, with market full of startups and support from the banking sector and the government. According to a report by National Association of Software and Services Company, there are about 400 firms in India with a large amount of foreign investments invested in fintech market. As per the report, the fintech software and services market of India is expected to grow into an $8 billion market by 2020.
So, Ravisha, what are the main components of fintech ecosystem in India?
The main components of fintech ecosystem in India will decide the future of fintech in India are the growing number of startups. The another main component that affects the future of the industry is government and its regulators. The government of India, through its various initiatives like Startup India, is providing a necessary support to the firms working to create technological innovation to promote the cashless economy. Established financial institutions are providing enough back in by collaborating with these startups devoted to the vision of glorious emergence of fintech industry. Apart from these, the role of incubators and accelerators cannot be denied in this ecosystem. They play an important role in providing necessary funding and keeping the ecosystem financially strong and sound that can grow further. Other factors driving this industry forward are the high rate of technology adoption, massive internet penetration, and increasing working population of India. In a very little time, India has become one of the most leading nations in fintech innovation. The financial technology is reforming the lives of Indian citizens and is a step forward to the creation of digital economy.